Too open. Too open.
And find guys like Grissel and the shooters.
Here is Grissel. And good ball movement to Zierden for three. And that finally drops in the first basket of the game.
With them when different centers are guarding.
Here is Hender wide open for three. Long rebound, and it comes to Watson. Small guards back there. Zierden leaves it, and an open shot. And a basket that time for Toby Hegner. So Hegner giving Creighton a 10-6 lead.
Some easy ones.
Hegner is 2 of 3, the rest of the team 1 of 12. So the good thing that Hegner, the sophomore from Berlin, Wisconsin, has shown some semblance of getting the ball in the hoop. Watson and Hegner. And Bevel playing up on Hegner, who hits his third three. They get Cooley going more to his bench than he anticipated. Zierden gets it in. And a basket by Hansen. Zach Hansen, who doesn't be able to see the game and see the complexion of it. Here is Watson and Dunn defending against him. Watson trying to penetrate against the bigger guy. Leaves it beautifully for Zach Hansen. Great play.
If I'm Providence, Chris Dunn's got Maurice Watson corralled. There's no need to kind of rotate over if you're Jalen Lindsey or Ben Bentel. Stay attached to the bigs. See how they're going to rotate over, open up the pass.
Nowhere to go in the lane. Huff looking for Hansen. And the lob pass in the basket. Watson again. And the field. And this is not the first time we've seen it. Tyron Cartwright does it go. Gets the rebound. And here is Ronnie Harrell Jr. Watson scoops and misses. Harrell follows with the left hand. So the freshman
just came out, sat on the bench.
Thomas with a three-point miss. But Zach Hansen follows. Oh, Zach Hansen. None on Watson. Watson trying to beat him off the dribble. Hansen trying to set a screen at the top. Now posting up against Bevel. And here's Watson working his way in against the basket. His first field goal. Helter Skelter, my friend. Here's Watson in the corner. Hegner is open for three. Not this time, but the rebound keeps it alive by Kyrie Thomas. Here's Zierden. He hits the three. Will somebody hit a three? And it was Zierden. And a 9-point lead. They're ranked 12th. They're more than best.
Yeah.
Milligan on the drive. And it goes. James Milligan got fouled the last time. Gets the. This is the closest Providence has come since 12 and a half to go in the first when it was only a 7-6 game. Here comes Watson. Watson answers with a basket and a foul. What a great answer. Seven on the clock. Here's Watson. Two on the clock. Going inside. Grissel, as the clock reached zero, lays it in to give Creighton a three-point lead.
What
a
outside.
Let's see if they try to go inside like you suggest. Pretty good percentage move, I would think, Nick. Zierden can't get the three off because of Dunn. They go into Grissel. That's the recipe. That's what you pointed. What Marquette did.
That's right. They got the block to win the game.
And three guys on Dunn. They said, let someone else beat us. And they couldn't. 10 on the shot clock. And here is Dunn. Ball knocked away with a steal. Watson. Dunn stays with him step for step. 15 plus seconds left. And here is Watson. Reverse layup ties the game.
job by Maurice Watson finding a seam and getting all the way to the basket for the layup.
Bullock will inbound to Dunn. 9 seconds to go. This is the finish. Or overtime. Dunn, fall away. It goes through. It goes through and Providence wins. Chris Dunn with a basket. Looked like it may be in and out. It went through.